The wait is finally over. The Roland V-160 Macropack is finally here. My name is Jeremy and I've spent the past 2 years slowly building this Macropack. And in this video, I'm going to demonstrate some of the key features and ways you can use it to its fullest in your productions. So here we have the pack running on a Stream Deck XL via Bitfocus Companion. This is the main way I recommend you use this, but it is not the only way. If you wanted to, you can run this via the macros in the Roland remote control software, but I do not recommend that because it is such a better workflow inside of Companion. But by all means, you've got the ability to run it via an iPad or the remote control software. So it's personal preference, but I'm going to be showing you how I operate with it. So here it is on the Stream Deck. We have our four main pages. You've got the Roland macros. This will give you all of your animated macros, which gives you control over all four pips, which is awesome. You've got your preset memory, which is some preset looks for you, which you can cut to very quickly. You've got your pip sources if you need to change the source of a pip. This is in both the Roland macros and the preset memories. And below that, we've got a Roland switcher, just a small little switcher panel just for you guys to use. Say you're away from the switcher and need to control it. This little page is not much, but it should help you with your productions. So let's go back to the macros. Here we have the Roland macros page. Let's cut back to me. Here I am. Hello. Now let's go do some fun. Let's go to a two box crop. There we go. Here I am. I'm coming in. Let's go to three boxes. Wait, what's better than three boxes? How about four boxes? There we go. And you can go full on all of these and bring it back. Here we go. Hello, hello. Go to four full. There we go. And it is very, very powerful. Let's go to the most common look that I always use every Sunday in my church. Here's the two box prayers left. Here I am, you have your camera, presenter on the left side. But here's the issue. Sometimes you've got two projectors and your presenter wants to look at the other one. You don't want them looking off into dead space. So that's why we also built one for the right side, which so you can easily change between those. It's super easy and very, very useful. So you can go back to four full. And then if you have a look here, you've got your two box pairs left and your two box pairs right. Let's go back to me. Here is your three box pairs. Something a bit different. You can have two guests on that side or do whatever you want to do. Or you can have three guests and your presentation feed, which is awesome. You can go full on any of these and it is wonderful. You've also got some other fun ones. You've got two box full, but since you've also, it's very similar to the two box crop, you've got the button here and it'll just do a little bounce out to get that. So you can do some fun things like go in, out, in, out, in, out. And that is very fun. But what's better than that? We've also got four box. Here we are in all that glory. We can do the same thing. We can go in, out, in, out, in, out. There's one thing I wanted to remake, because there's lots of fun in the demo pack when you first get your Roland. I wanted to make the four box fade. So if I push this one, there we go. Wonderful. And that is kind of what inspired me to make this whole pack, not gonna lie. So let's keep going. We have some preset memories. Let's go to one box. We have two box. We have three box and we have four box. We have one box crop, two box crop, three box crop, four box crop. And it is good. We've got one prez left, two prez left, three prez left. We've also got one prez right, two prez right, three prez right, which is awesome. We've got two fill again, and we've got four fill. We've also got the lower thirds, which aren't set up right now, so I'm not going to show those, but when you've got a downstream key source set up, it works great. I don't have that set up, but trust me, it works great. We've also got a few custom programmable buttons. We've got 23, which is just some fun changes I had last minute as I was wrapping this up. Feel free to have a bit of fun with this. And yeah. And last but not least, we've got the two box press center. Here we go. And you can also turn on your DSKs on and off with these two buttons here. Once you've messed with these, I recommend going back to the default one, which is preset memory number one. And this gets you back ready to use the animated macros again. Now let's go back to the Roland macro page one last time. Let's go to Toolbox Prescribed to show you one last feature. So here we have up and down arrows. These are very useful. Say you've changed pages and you go back to the macros. You are now on a different macro. Let's use these to navigate back to the macro we were on. Toolbox Prescribed, and then you can do clean transitions without any weirdness happening with the picture in pictures. Now let's navigate to Pip Sources. Here we are now in a toolbox crop. Here we can change what is in either of our pips. One really important note to make though is when you change those sources and when you want to go back to one full, it changes. That is because inside the macro, it is programmed to go to a specific source on the switcher. Let me show you how to change that live in production really quickly. Here we are inside of the Roland remote control software on an iPad. If we go to say one full in our edit page, you can see what the macro is actually doing. Here you can see it says program take cut. If we go into that and we change the source to say SDI2 and we go back to our macro, if we then go to say toolbox crop and we then change the left box to say here and then we go to one full, it will fill the frame up. That was also a demonstration of why you should go to the right page, otherwise you'll get weird stuff like that. But as in all your other macros, you've got a full ride, you've got it going to SDI7, so look for that in your macros and it'll let you change them there. If you have questions, please ask below. Now let's move on to the Roland switcher page. So here we are on the Roland switcher page. You've got some preview and program buttons. So you've got your previews lined up. Here we are. You can see them on the multi-view going left and right. You can bring program, change it up. And you've also got your auto and cut button. So you can cut super easy. But you've also got your mix and fam, so you can make a nice mix. You can make a wipe, you can do a fam, and also a nam. Right above it, you can change how long you want the transition to last. So here we have it, it's gonna last for a nice 4 seconds. So let's do a nice long transition. Here we go, whoa. It is very good. Nam is kind of cool, but yeah, and it works. We've also got our pip button. So say you want to bring a pip on, you can push once, it'll bring it into preview. Push it again, it'll bring it onto program. That's the same for all these pips. It's also the same with the DSKs. So once those are set up, they will come on right away. You can also change your wipes right here. So say you want to go to here, you got a nice fun, some fun wipes. Whoa. Very fun. You've also in the top here got your pages which you can go to. So you can go to the macro page, go back to your pip sources and your preset memory, which is awesome. When I release this, these buttons will probably be switched around to the right way so they are reflective of how they are in here. That'll come just before the macro pack is released. We've also got one last page in here. We've got the PTZ control. I know this isn't for everyone, but I use it, so I may as well show you how it works. So if we go to a PTZ camera, here's our camera in our auditorium. We can go right, we can go left, you can go all the control you could want. You got zoom fast, you got zoom out fast, you got zoom slow, which is the slowest that you can set inside the module. You've also got some buttons, so say you want to make the PTZ super slow. There you go. It's like a slow crawl or medium, not too much faster, fast. We can control multiple cameras here. Feel free to customize it as you want, but this is what we use and it does a good job for us. Before I finish this video, I want to thank the amazing Brandon Peltz from A2Z Production/Live Production Mastery. It was an amazing job on the A10 macro pack, which of course this pack is heavily inspired by. I also want to thank the Roland macro testers from the V160 users group who have helped me every step of the way as I've developed this wonderful macro pack. I also want to thank Joseph Adams for your help develop the V160HD module and companion, plus those who helped financially to get the module made. Thank you so much. And last but not least, I want to thank Mark Allen, my Roland rep from Melbourne, Australia. Thank you so much for bearing with me every step of the way as I've made this. And if you're downloading this after watching this video, I do wish you the best. Feel free to send me a message or leave a comment below this if you have any questions. I'm happy to answer them to a certain extent. I believe there's compatibility with other Roland switches that support macros, but that is purely depends on the model and how many pips. According to Roland, they told me that it'll possibly only work with the ones with the amount of pips you have. So say you have a switcher that only supports two pigeon pitches, it'll only use the two pigeon pitches. But of course, if you want to use this as full functionality, it needs to have a Roland, a companion module, which if your switches does not, you won't be able to use its full capacity, but you're inside the remote control software, you'll still be able to trigger the macros. So that's all I can say for that at the moment. There's a potential I may make another version for other launch switches in the future if there's demand for it. This is taking me a long time to make. So making those other macro packs may not be too much of a challenge, but it's just the time, of course, to get this done and to get it done right. So if there's demand for it, I may make it. But either way, I think this is a really good starting off point for people to take what I've made and customize it. I really encourage that. This is free to the community. Take it, enjoy it, mess around with it. Make sure you back up the settings on the switches first, just in case, because I don't want you to damage your switches. Just take time and read the manual. If you would like to get some of your switches modules made, like for example, the VR120, I don't believe, I may be wrong, but I don't believe that it has support for it inside it. I'm a companion. But if you would like to, please reach out to Joseph Adams. He did an amazing job in the V160 pack. And if I can send work his way, please do. He's a great guy to work with. He'll deal with all your annoying questions, because I know I asked him quite a few. And yeah, thank you so much for watching and happy switching. Bye-bye.